Well, it is the start of a new week, and it's another one where Minneapolis Public School students, teachers, and most staff aren't in school. Yesterday, the district issued what it called its last, best, and final offer to the union. The offer would bump the average pay of an educational support professional, or you've heard the term ESPs, by 15% over the next 2 years. And that would bring the average salary of an ESP to $35,000 a year. The district says it cannot go any higher. As they have been every day since the strike started several days ago, teachers and people who support our educators were out this afternoon. And Sharon, you went out there to get a feel for things at this point in the strike.
Yeah, so most everyone there, including students, said they were hopeful the two sides would eventually come to a conclusion. But the biggest thing today was that everyone really missed each other in school.
10 days away, and distance has made hearts grow fonder.
Welcome, welcome.
It's odd, breaking routine.
When our babies walk through that door, they're ours. They are ours for 7.5 hours a day, and they belong to us. We teach them, we love them, we make sure that they're taken care of, and then we send them home and we do it all over again the next day.
Melisha Carroll, a family and community liaison at Lucy Laney, says she's lucky because sometimes her students will come drive down with their parents to say hi.
What about the kids?
And to share love at the picket line. But other than that, she says she knows.
They're just at home. They're bored. They're going crazy. They tell us that they miss us.
And the feelings are mutual.
We worry about our kids and want to know that they're okay. So we pretty much hold each other up out here while we're out here all day, every day.
Especially as a special ed teacher, it's hard seeing my students because I've worked so hard to build relationships with them, and just not seeing them, I know how hard it is for them at home right now.
I mean, I think about our kids every day. They're, like I said, my department specifically, I work in the DCD department, so they're probably really confused as to why they've been out for 10 days. A lot of them love to come to school just for like the social community here, different activities to see their friends or see their teacher. Like, it's a lot of highlights of their days.
The educators worry that when they finally do get back, progress would have been lost.
It's going to be like starting all over again. But what can we do? This is overdue for us. We need better pay, seriously. We need smaller size classrooms. We need respect. And so far, they're not showing us any.
But progress in school is not what some students were worried about.
I would be more worried if this situation isn't fixed now, because it's not only me that's going to be held back, but everybody else. Like, every MPLS kid right now in this district is going to feel hurt. And if we don't fix it right now, then how will the kids of tomorrow, the kids that will be born, the kids that will go into the system, be affected?
Students should always support teachers in what they do because they're the ones who are teaching us. So it should be right that we are giving back to them and helping them.
I think it's really important. The teachers have always been here for us, and we need to be here for them too. And this is like a group effort. We're all just here supporting each other.
Every staff member and teacher who is holding the picket line has been actually going without pay for the past 10 days. We even saw some teachers on Twitter putting out their Venmo and PayPal information because this coming Friday is actually payday for them. So I asked Minneapolis Federation of Teachers President Greta Callahan about those tweets.
Friday will be our first missed paycheck. And that's why, like, community support right now, what we're seeing is beautiful. We're seeing so many families giving directly to Venmo or whatever people are asking for. But at the end of the day, we have a strike fund that is doing direct bill pay for our members. And so if people would contribute to the strike fund, that's going to help everyone here who has risked it all for the children of Minneapolis.
Most days, the school district actually has been posting updates on the situation. At last check, they haven't posted an update yet in terms of coming to an agreement. Jana.
Yeah, it's worth noting you and I and others here at CARE, we've been trying to talk to the district today, and they just said we don't have anything yet. So we're trying to get that voice out there. We just haven't heard.
Yeah, the updates are sporadic, so they might come later tonight. So stay tuned.
All right. Thanks so much, Sharon.